Superchargers, my favorite thing about them is not only do you get the cool turbocharger sounds, but you also get the whine, like the whine. You get the whine too.
What are the three different types of superchargers?
Awesome, awesomer, and awesomest.
Roots type, I believe, is one of them.
You got the centrifugal or centripetal?
No, start with the European explanation.
Oh, you want that one.
Centrifugal, roots, screw.
How do superchargers work?
Supercharger typically will run off a belt, and it's forcing air into the system, into the intake system, making more power.
So superchargers are driven off the engine, off the crankshaft of the engine typically, so via belt, gear, some sort of drive, some sort of rotating mechanism.
It effectively does the same thing as a turbocharger, but instead of using exhaust gases or sucking exhaust gases, it uses a belt drive type system to create that, to pull in that extra air.
And they basically are big air compressors, more or less. So they're bolted to the engine, they're driven off the engine, and they compress air and shove it into the engine.
Do we like listening to the Roots?
Absolutely amazing band.
Hell yeah. Yeah. You kidding me?
From time to time, yeah.
Questlove is the man, so.
Roots style superchargers? Don't get me started. They're spectacular.
Do you have one in the Scirocco?
The Scirocco is a Roots style supercharger.
That is some juicy. That is a fun car.
What are some examples of supercharged European cars?
There's quite a few that come from the factory supercharged. Mercedes-Benz, the M113K engine was used in a lot of cars in the early 2000s and mid 2000s. So you have like the SL55 AMG.
EW211 E55 AMG, Dapper Cruise.
You got AMGs, you have Audis.
G60s,
Volkswagen,
yeah.
G60. Is
there an
Audi? Yes, yes, the 3-liter TFSI. That's like the newest supercharged engine. So yeah, big Roots blower sitting right on top of that thing.
What is better for making big power? Supercharging or turbocharging?
The bottom line is superchargers are mechanically driven by the engine itself, usually off the crankshaft, so there is some power robbing that's happening there. Depending on the size of the supercharger, it actually may need up to a third of the crank horsepower to actually drive the supercharger and make usable boost. So for a supercharger to work, you do need to give up some power. Turbochargers, which are using the exhaust gases, you're not using any mechanical power. You're actually using waste energy to provide more energy. So technically, turbochargers, way more efficient, not technically, they just are more efficient.
More efficient.
And because they're more efficient, you do make more power.
I would say turbocharging is the way to go, simply for the fact that it's more efficient.
Turbocharging is just by design more efficient. So if you want to make big power, start with a turbocharger.
I can't believe it's butter. It all tastes the same. At the end of the day, it's really what you want, you know?
What makes a supercharger whine?
Compressor vanes are filling with compressed air, thus creating that sound.
You're probably gonna also wanna Google that.
Well, I've already addressed this. It only whines if it's a screw type supercharger.
What is an aftercooler?
Sounds similar to an intercooler, except after.
Is it for like Corvettes that overheat, like Corvette ZR or Z06 at the supercharger?
Is it after the supercharger, cools down the intake charge, right? There you go.
Aftercooler is a cooling device that lives after the supercharger. So obviously, an intercooler is plumbed all into it. An aftercooler would be something that lives somewhere between the supercharger and the intake of the car to cool down the charge. What's up, YouTube? Do you have questions about your car that you're a little embarrassed to ask? Leave them in the comments below and we'll address them in a future episode.
You know YouTube doesn't watch our videos.
I'm just doing what I'm told to do. I'm a Muppet here.